For any data architecture that you're building out, having storage is going to be a critical component. We're going to focus on here today, Azure Blob Storage and Azure Files. I actually found a pretty nice way to explain the differences. If we look at this here, Azure Blob is object storage. This is where you're going to store massive amounts of data, unstructured data that does not really need to be any specific type, whereas the file storage is more like a typical hard drive once it's mounted. They have some great examples of when you would use blob storage, like we said, maybe images, streaming, log files, backups, just big data, doesn't have to be specific, it's an object. Whereas file storage is going to be replacing or supplementing on-premise file servers. Think of, again, like a hard drive. But we're gonna start with blob storage here. The name blob's kind of funky. It's always fun to say, but the way we're gonna set this up is in three parts. We'll set up a blob storage account. Second, we'll create containers. You can think of containers as just different ways to organize all of this vast data that's coming in. For example, videos or pictures, or maybe you have certain applications or source systems where you want to split it up a certain way. That's how you could do that here. And then blob is the atomic level here. These are those individual files or objects that will be uploaded. There's three different, I guess, classifications of blobs. We're not going to get into it too much, but you'll see that as we build. It will give you the option for these three. And if you ever want to learn a little bit more about these, there's plenty of documentation on Azure, and I'll link this here as well. Okay, enough of this. Let's get into actually building this out. We'll start with the blob and then we'll get into the file storage. So what we'll do here back in our Azure portal, we'll go to more services and all services. And since through all these demos, we're using that free tier, let's go here to free services. Front and center, we see the two options here, Azure Blob, file storage. Because it's free, it's giving us a limit. It looks like 5 gigabytes, but again, we're just doing it for demo and learning purposes. So this is plenty. Create. And we'll walk through just how simple it is to actually set this up. Now here, if we look at subscription and resource group, if you're not familiar with what this is, take a look at the other video. We walk through these concepts and how to organize it. So we'll keep this as is. All right, storage account name. We have to give this storage account a name. Again, remember here, we're now creating this account. Instead of production, we'll call this KDS Blob Storage. I'm gonna move this to central, it's closer to me. Performance, you could pick standard, which is recommended. Premium, if you really need that low latency, quick access to all this information, for whatever reason you need that, that's something to look into, but we'll stick with standard. Next is advanced, and here you can lock down different security features. Maybe you don't want it to be publicly accessible for the blob. You can select that here, Azure Directory impacts. There's all sorts of stuff here. We're not going to get too specific, but again, there's a lot of options here, and I think what's important to point out is how you can really lock this down security-wise pretty tightly. Same with networking here. So do you want it to have public endpoint so anyone can see it, or do you want to have it locked down so only specific networks or IPs can actually get to this? So another nice way of restricting access to this data here, you can add some more settings such as soft deletes if you want, tags, we're not going to add any, review and create. All right, so it just did a quick validation and that passed. Now we'll click create and it gives us this deployment screen so we can see this is deploying. If you want to go to inputs and see exactly what values it's using to create this, you can check that out here. All right, deployment complete. Let's click go to resource. And here we are. So we're in our storage account. And what we can do next is create a container. And all this information is here. This is everything we've set up. It has all configurations and there's really all these different things you can do for this. But what we'll focus on is the storage component. And if we look here, we see containers. So let's click in here and there's a default one for logs. And here we can create now our containers. And if we hop back here, now this is where we're at. We just created our storage account. Now we're going to create a container and upload a specific, just a single blob object to this. All right, so let's click plus container. We'll give this container a name. We'll call this demo container. I need to come up with some better naming, but whatever. Here's another place where you can restrict access. Again, it's very granular how you can do this on Azure in general. Security is really as tight as you want it to be. And we'll go ahead and create this. Now it's created. We go in here, nothing in here. So now let's upload some file. Now we have this container, and imagine in a real world setting, this is where you would have this large amount of unstructured data consistently flowing in here and populating your container. But what we'll do is manually upload. So I'm going to click upload and select a file. I have this JSON file here. It's just a name and locations, nothing special, but it's a JSON file. We'll open this and you can have the setting to overwrite if it already exists. Some more settings here. You can have a specific folder if you'd like. And here's that blob type. Remember, we mentioned there are three types. Here's where you can change that. Okay, so upload. And here it is. We've officially uploaded our first blob. Each blob gets a specific URL, so you can actually get to that very specific object from a URL. Some more security options here. You can edit, you can actually see it. So here's the file that I uploaded. Like I said, it's just very simple, but that's what it looks like. It's all here. You can change all sorts of properties, restrict access, you know, the whole works. And that is the whole process of the blob storage. Next, let's look at Azure Files, which is going to be that file storage version, which we mentioned is more similar to your traditional hard drive. Let's go ahead and do that. Free services, Azure File Storage. Let's create this one now. We'll run through this here. It'll be the same options. ADS File Storage Central. Next, validation, create. Okay, complete. Let's go to the resource. Very similar look and feel. It's a storage account. It's just a different type of storage. Instead of blob, it's files. And everything will look very similar here. We can go to containers and go through the same process that we just did. So we'll call this demo container, create, and we'll upload, and I'll upload a different type of file. It's a doc. Same thing, but the purposes for why you would use them would be slightly different, as we've covered. If we go down to storage accounts, we can see we have blob storage, file storage, they're both covered under here, which leads to the last point, which is kind of putting this in perspective of the overall architecture and why you may even want to do this in the first place. Maybe you just want to upload files and that's totally fine. Just use it as your own personal storage. But if you're looking for more of a cloud data architecture, here is kind of an overview of what you're doing. Where this would actually come into play would be more of this data lake concept. You can think of, as we mentioned, the blob storage is where you're putting all of that big data. A lot of it could be unstructured. So you could have sources coming from APIs, from your source database applications, maybe FTP uploads, any of these different types. And what it's going to do is get put into some large storage container or multiple containers and then moved along the way. So in this example, maybe you're using something like Data Factory, it could be something else, to extract it, load it into your blob storage, or maybe this is some sort of a streaming process, not Data Factory, and then move it into a data warehouse. For example, Synapse, maybe this is Snowflake, something else. And from there, those could be moved into data models, like in analysis services, which then connect to Power BI. And what we're focused on here is blob storage or any storage. And it's kind of that landing zone for all of these different types. And maybe each of these get their own container as a way to organize it. And if that's not clear, we have this visual here from Microsoft as well. And I think this is nice because they have the different icons and whatnot. But you can see here, same concept. We have the different data sources. And in this case, obviously all Microsoft getting put into the storage blob, which then get moved from there to something a little more structured, which would be that Azure Synapse, and moved along the way. Same concept. Thank you for watching. Let me know if you have any questions and we'll see you at the next video.